finals.
Finals, finally.
Finals, finally. If you were following this stream that we make, stream of videos, we are commenting on the Super 6 tournament battles that Kazna won till this moment. And they are in finals and they are playing against Efe, right?
Tactical Turtle team, but it's Efe.
Yeah, they got a guy from Fire, that's why probably they called themselves Tactical Turtle. Anyhow, let's see, you are playing Grimberg, and can you comment on tanks, or can you comment on anything?
As you can see, they have 3 heavies, 4 lights. We are pretty much similar, maybe we have one faster tank, so we are going to take over the green field. And that is supposed to be done pretty fast.
Supposed to be done. Now they are already there.
Yeah, there are some side shots delivered.
You're connecting them, they're connecting you, right?
Yes, and there is one mistake that happened in this game, which we'll see a bit later. And that practically ended us.
One mistake,
and we fell like dominoes.
Okay, they are punishing T37 city and they
yes,
killed it.
Yes, I think we should just see this from another perspective.
Who are we looking at this moment?
We are looking at a little Zish, who is going to flank them as supposed to. And he's supposed to go on that sandbags on the left, climb them in secure position and harass them from there permanently.
But he managed to do Coyote. He did a Coyote, right?
Yeah, he saw some red dots and he decided to just shoot them from the open.
Okay, so he's trying now to... he was tracked.
No, he was out of the position. There is no cooldown position here. This is not an IS Sever.
Oh my god, they killed the bastard. They killed Kenny!
They killed Kenny!
He was surprised by KV-85s.
So, he was supposed to be...
He was supposed to be in that upper position there, where they can't connect him.
Okay, so what are you gonna do now?
Well, we're pretty in a bad position now. They have map control, not a good thing for us. We're calling for heavy tanks to approach, and as you can see, we are pretty confused. And they're not giving them us initiative. They're actually taking it with higher numbers.
They are pushing, right?
They're pushing us, and we are all over the place doing nothing.
You're going back.
We are bouncing left and right of each other, as you can see, getting shot wherever we move.
This is not a great performance by you.
It's very lucky, I would say.
My god, they killed Yikanji, they killed Jeanette.
Red team is dominating!
There, it's on fire, it's 4-0. It's 5-0. Will you make score at least 6-0, one kill?
We are pacifist, we believe in peaceful solutions and everything, you know?
But red team doesn't believe.
No, they believe that power is okay.
7-0. So, you do some purpose?
Mighty Kazna.
You want to lose this game? And we are looking at the second game, and once again the opponent team is winning by 1, and they have a match point, right?
I find your lack of faith disturbing.
I wouldn't say so. This is best of 5. It's a final match.
So you have like one more game here to lose, yes?
Before it's a match
point. You can lose one more game.
We can say first match was a training match for them. We were dummies.
Okay, so did you change the lineup?
Absolutely a little.
What did you do?
We took one heavy tank more.
You realize that you need more HP?
No, I changed tactics.
What do you do?
As you can see, we are pushing city for the first time. We are taking over the corner to spot, and we are going with our heavy tanks to cover us instantly.
And you managed to surprise their...
It was kind of, as Zizhu said, a mind game that worked.
What do you mean?
He didn't expect them in the city. We had an argument before the match, and at one moment I just cut it and said, we are going there.
Okay, so basically that T57 is toast, as I think.
5960 already died, he's on low HP, now they're as desperate as we were in previous game.
They are pushing and you're punishing them from side, right?
Yes, you will see it. I think you should switch to another perspective.
So this several seconds before that all happened, you killed that scout.
Yes, and you can see they are in a crossfire now, that's what we wanted. For all the time. Yes. We have... people that can shoot from 3 angles, and they are in a problem. The original plan was if there is no one, he can go to the fountain and take it while we are taking the middle street. but they fell in our crossfire.
But why didn't they just move back?
Does it really matter? They already lost one tank and lost half HP another. And they didn't know, are we all there, are we not, what are we doing?
So they pushed...
They decided to push in our 3 KV-85s.
They thought that there was only 3 KV... They wanted our match.
Yes, they wanted to kill them fast.
But that was a bad decision?
I think they lost the game when they lost the first guy. Basically, every other move was forced.
They lost extremely huge number of HP traversing to that cleared section.
Because while they were losing him, other guys took HP, lost HP also, and they were in really bad position.
You change a little bit your setup. You have 2 KV-85, right?
Yeah, one heavy less again.
Why?
And they have, as you can see, instead of 59-16, T-34-85. Why exactly that? Maybe because that guy has it. It's still a medium that does damage like a heavy tank.
You think it is a better or worse choice to take T-34-85?
Or 59-16 is better, definitely.
Better?
Yes. 59-16 is good for ESL when other T-rates are shooting over its spots, but in actions like this, I don't like it that much.
Okay, so you are again going to the fields, again going to the houses.
No, we're actually doing it quite differently. It's details, devil lies in details.
Details, so tell us, what's the detail there?
So we're pressing the middle so they see us. Zish is actually doing good thing now, going straight where he's supposed to go.
Not shooting at the...
Not shooting and then moving. As you can see, we are buying some time here, and our KV-85s are on the street. Okay. This is what we want. This is what I was telling before. Show one hand while doing your job with other.
So these are not the tanks you are looking for.
Yes, this is just an illusion. Actually, we are running away. All but FKK, who has a hearing problem, so he will come a little later.
FKK, get back, dude!
It was like Moro. Dude, did you notice we already left? See ya, bro!
Tunnel vision is something that's very common in the video game.
No, actually, he waited to fade. I understand that, but it was kind of risky.
Okay.
And this is what we wanted to do as a reaction. So they committed on a game like they were used to. They were expecting we are again doing the same. But as you can see on the map...
And they're pushing at this moment,
and
right?
They are expecting us to be there.
Yeah, but you are not there. You are with fast tanks, you are moving around.
We are already all around the world.
And you are trying to cap, right?
We are trying to get a better position. To force their move and to force them to go on some open field where you can shoot them. Like, you have to realize one thing. Cap is a good weapon if you can win by it, but it's even better if you just force other team
pressure.
To react.
It creates pressure. Yes.
Yes.
And look at that. You're gonna make it to the houses if you make.
I'm
it
gonna
to
go
houses.
There, and two guys will cap.
Oh my God, that's excellent position. They didn't left anyone here to.
No.
That's a mistake.
That's a big mistake. They already should have at least one guy here.
Yeah, and to spot
at least
you.
One.
Okay, so they are now in open field.
They're in a problem. The clock is ticking now.
Yeah, and you get 2 KV-85s.
And now we are pressuring from the other side with KV-85s and Cromwell, and T-37 is shooting from the middle also.
Again, crosshairs.
Crossfire,
I'm very sorry. Crossfire, yes, that's what I want to say. And the T-37 are coming.
They are coming desperately now. They have to reset no matter what.
Oh my God, 77, 81, 85. And somebody managed to reset, but they lost the tank. They lost two tanks and they're
dying all over the place now.
Yes, like flies. And you are punishing that pure.
And we are playing really aggressive on the middle, sacrificing tanks. So we are doing what we are supposed to. We cleared out the decappers. We did everything to hold them off. And now we're just relying on cap.
And that will happen...
any second.
And you managed to cap. You managed to cap, excellent.
Mm-hmm. As you can see, if Yukanji didn't move back, now he would actually be reseted.
Okay, so... Fourth game, decider for you. Now you have the match point, and they have a really strange setup. They switch to two, they get two 59-16. Why is that?
I have you now.
This is a mind game. So, they decided to play it really fast and maybe rush us. That's what we are seeing now.
But you had Darth Vader with you.
The power is strong within us always.
Okay, so what's gonna happen now? Tell me.
So we see their lineup and then we are deciding to go to the center. Yes, they can reach it faster, but we know how to drive there pretty much safely and to approach with 3 KV-85s. Once KV-85s are in their face, they will lose the game. Unless they're in a city, but we're gonna check for that too. If you can see how we are driving left our light tanks, one guy is going on the right and checking it out, so we don't fall in a trap.
Okay, so you see them, alright.
We are committing straight away.
You are deciding that brawl is your best option.
Definitely.
Okay,
so I think we should change the perspective now, you will understand why.
So, we are looking at Hikanji, Mr. Siemka.
Mr. Siemka, Superstellar himself.
Okay, this is a few seconds before the contact. And
this is what I was talking about. When our heavy tanks get close enough, they're toast, whether they realize it or not.
But they are pushing that top part of the map, and they are continuing to push the top part.
Yes, but our tanks are also taking a kind of a hold-on positions and pushing between the buildings.
And they are.
Light. And our lights are like infantry after them, going to let them soak up the damage while we are fighting.
Huh, so at this moment, ooh, that hurt.
They're in a problem.
Yeah, that.
We had a little drama on the right corner here. There was a guy, you see the red dot there? Mm-hmm. And I tunnel vision so much I didn't see it, and I was still, the guy on the right. I was like, what guy on the right? The guy on the right, dude, the one that's shooting at you. I was like, oh.
So, 2-0, and it looks like it's one game, basically. I mean, let's see how it's gonna play out.
As you can see, we are really into them. We are not letting them run away, separate or do whatever. We are just pressuring them constantly because brawl is what is good for us. Sniping is good for them.
Yeah, this 3-1, they kill somebody, but that one will die from
there. They're falling.
They're falling like flies, right?
Yeah, we read them, what they're doing, and that's about that.
So, tell me, what was wrong with this tactic? Their tactic, was it wrong from the beginning?
They committed too fast without knowing where we are. And once they did, it was too late. Our reaction was impeccable.
So what should they do instead? They should send scouts, try to maneuver around, maybe...
Maybe not play like that. Sorry to say it, but they gave up on their original playstyle too early.